All right, here we are back again in Illustrator. We're gonna be moving on to lesson three, which is how to create images from scratch, how to create your own objects using some of the basic tools. Before we start, I wanna show you where we're kind of headed. You do not have to open this file. You can if you want to. My example is called Teacher Example in the Lesson 3 folder if you wish to open it up. Again, you do not have to open this, but I want to show you what we're basically going to be doing here. We're going to be creating a house from scratch. Yours will look significantly different than this. I'm going to go ahead and just pull that down. Actually, let's go ahead and close that. I don't need that now. All right, so now I'd like you to follow along. We're going to start by creating a new document, which is most of the time what you're going to be doing in Illustrator. Let's go to File, New. A couple things you need to check. Number one, we want this to be a portrait orientation, which means going up and down, not side to side. So make sure that your portrait is checked. Double check to make sure that your units are set on inches. And by default, it should be 14 by 20. Okay, and click OK. We now have a rectangle. Let's immediately save this. File, Save As. Navigate back to your lessons folder, wherever that might be. If it's in an Illustrator folder or a print shop folder, mine happens to be in my print shop folder. And I'd like you to call it Lesson 3. Now, a quick little tidbit here, something to consider is that when you're naming files, don't use punctuation. So don't use periods or commas, backslashes, if you can help it at all, because what that does is it will tend to corrupt a file because it thinks that you're doing coding. So make sure you have no punctuation in your file names and click Save. This is going to pop up. Just click OK. All right. Couple things before we get started. We're going to turn something on called the Smart Guides. What Smart Guides does is it helps you line things up when you're doing freehand drawings like we're going to be doing. So let's go to View and double check to make sure that Smart Guides is checked. If not, simply click on that. It will add the check mark. Okay, it's not going to look like anything happened, but we now have our guides on, and I'll point that out to you when we start drawing here. The next thing I want to point out is that we're going to be talking about the drawing modes. Most of the time, you need to make sure that your drawing mode is here set on Draw Normal. If I let it hover, it's going to pop up. It's going to show you. You have Draw Behind, which we will use one time during this lesson, and we have Draw Inside. So just so you know where those three things are, you might want to write that down in your notes. Draw a little doodle if you need to. All right. We're going to go ahead and start by showing you how to draw some basic shapes with the basic shape tools a couple of different ways. First of all, your shape tools are in this drawer here. Okay, we're going to start with the rectangle tool. As you can see, the shortcut button is M. The easiest way to do this is to simply click. We're going to do that. But before we do, let's set our fill and stroke. So you're going to choose the color that you want the front of your house to be. I want a nice subtle gray. I want you to make sure that your stroke here, this is the outline, is set to none. So as I make my changes in my control up here, it should be changing down here as well. All right. And then all you have to do is come over to your image, click. This box should pop up. It's where you type in the exact measurements. Now this is nice if you know exactly how big you need something to be. In this case, we're going to do 4.7 inches. And you must put inches. If not, it's going to go back to the default in pixels. And you're going to end with this really teeny tiny box. So 4 by 7 inches for your width and 2.3 inches for your height. And click OK. And it created your box. All right. That's great if you know your dimensions, you know the size that you want things to be, but most of the time we don't. Most of the time you're going to draw it from scratch. So the other way that you can do that, make sure, first of all, let's deselect everything. So click in the white space or go up to select, deselect, which is right here. We're going to change our color for our fill. I want you to pick a color that you want for your front door. Again, leave it at set to no stroke. And you're just going to click, oops, you need to make sure that your rectangle tool is selected. Let me try that again. And you're going to click and drag. Now, here's where the smart guides come in. If you have smart guides on, it's going to pop up some words. It's going to snap things to it. So when I pull down my rectangle before I'm releasing, it kind of sucked it to that bottom edge of my larger rectangle there so that it lines them up correctly. It also showed me that in that word, see where it says path in green, that means it has located another path and it leveled it with that other path. And then you release, there's your door. I'm gonna zoom in here so I can see my house a little bit better. Let's go ahead and make a copy of this door. As a review, hold down Alt and move it over. Now again, with my smart guides on, I'm holding down Alt for my copy. Notice that green line is showing me that it's level with that other door. If I move it up, it's no longer level. So it's showing me when I'm level and when I'm not. And release. We're gonna flip this to make it a window, but before we do, let's change our color. Make it a window color, whatever you think a window color looks like. It can be white, doesn't matter. And we're gonna rotate this. A couple ways we can rotate this. The easiest way, so that you know you're rotating it exactly, is to open up something called the transform panel. So go up to window, go and open your transform panel. Mine's already open. And then you're gonna see here, if you let this hover, notice it says rotate. If I click on this and I go to 90 degrees, it's gonna rotate at 90 degrees. So obviously you can play with this a little bit. If I go 90 degrees, it goes the other way. So think of it as like clockwise, counterclockwise. So we want it on its side. Okay, pretty simple to do. So we're gonna move that over and make a window. Let's make another copy. And we're gonna move this up and we're gonna turn this into the chimney, right? You can also rotate it with what's called the rotate tool, which is over here in the drawer. If I click and hold, it's going to rotate my chimney. Now, if you look at your lines, with the rotate tool, it's all freehand. So it requires a steady hand to make sure that it's nice and level. With your selection tool, I want you to resize this, make it a relative chimney size, so not very big, doesn't have to be very big at all. And just move that over on one side of your house. Again, you don't even have to stack these in the same place as I'm at on my house. You can put your chimney to the right, I don't care. Okay, let's go to File, Save at this point so we don't lose any of our changes. And now I'm gonna show you how to add an elliptical rectangle. Rounded rectangle. So let's go back in that drawer and let's go to rounded rectangle. Let's set our colors. We're gonna do a little ledge on the window, so I'm gonna make a brown color here, leaving all of our stroke for right now, setting at none. And I'm gonna click and drag. If I wanna make, now you'll notice the corners are gone. If I wanna make it more or less severe, I use the arrow key. So I'm hitting down here, so it's making it less rounded. And if I go all the way to zero, it's gonna take all the rounding off. If I hit the up arrow, it's gonna round those corners. So you decide how rounded you want yours to be, and I want you to make it level with the window and slightly wider than the window. And you can move that once you use your selection tool, you can hit your arrow keys. So I just want you to make it slightly level, make a copy of that. We're gonna put that at the top of the chimney. We're gonna resize that so we've got a little lip on the top of the chimney. If you want to, you can change the color as well. Okay, so when I'm nudging my shapes or my objects here, all I'm doing is I'm going back to my selection tool and I'm using my arrow keys on my keyboard. So that's really beneficial when you're starting to do complex drawings like this where you want to nudge things, because sometimes the mouse is really fidgety and it doesn't like to move things small increments. So I use my arrow keys a lot for this. All right, last thing I want to do here is let's zoom in a little bit more on the door. And we're gonna create a half window, an elliptical window on the top of this. In order to do that, we're gonna grab our ellipse tool. Make sure you have nothing selected here. And we're gonna click and drag an ellipse. And I don't really care what color this is right now, but I wanna click and drag an ellipse that's the same width as the door. And you can see that it should be level. We can always move this if we need to. But I want you to draw an ellipse that's about as wide as the door is. Grab your selection tool and I want you to move that down so that it's level, the center part intersects with the top of the door. And here's how I'm gonna check this. Let's go to View Outline. It takes all the color off so we can see through our shapes. So now I wanna move that ellipse down so that this center point intersects with the top edge of the door. Do that now. All right, when you're done, all you have to go is back is to go to View Preview to bring all your color back. All right, and deselect. That's all I need you to do for that right now. and let's go to File, Save. Excellent. All right, we're gonna add a little crossbar across here. Don't worry, this window is not done. I know it doesn't look right. We're gonna fix it in a little bit. I'm showing you how you have to overlap shapes to create complex drawings. We need to grab our rectangle tool. Pick a different color. It does not matter what color this is because this square, this rectangle is actually gonna be gone by the time we're done. And I wanna click and drag a rectangle that splits this circle in half. So it splits right across the half. It does not necessarily have to be at that top of the door, but go ahead and do that now. So I've got an ellipse, I've got this weird rectangle across the top, and then I've got the door itself. When you do that, go ahead and go to File, Save. All right, we're gonna leave that for now. We're gonna come back to this when I show you how to combine shapes together, but I didn't wanna move on before we got that done. All right, now we're gonna go ahead and scroll out, zoom out a little bit so we can see a little bit more of the house. We're gonna draw the roof line now here. We're gonna use the polygon tool to do that. Polygon tool is in the drawer with the other shape tools. It's called polygon. I'm just gonna reset my essentials here real fast just in case my defaults from the last time I was playing around this hadn't changed. When you draw a polygon, it can be in multiple points. We're gonna draw a roof line here, so let's pick a color for a roof. I'm gonna pick a dark slate gray here. No stroke. When you click and drag, now when you drag, you might have more points to yours. It depends on whatever you did with it last. I may turn mine into 3 points. Here's how you increase and decrease the number of points. It's your arrow keys, but you have to be clicking and holding when you do this. So if I, right now I'm hitting my up arrow key, it's adding points. If I'm decreasing my points. So I want you to hit the arrow key down until you get 3 points and then continue clicking, dragging. I was holding my mouse down, excuse me, that entire time. If I hold down the shift key while I'm dragging, it's gonna hold that nice and level. So look at that bottom edge of that triangle. Notice it's nice and level. This doesn't need to be too big, but we do wanna make it slightly bigger than the house, and I'm gonna release. Now I'm just gonna move that down. Okay. I wanna move this arrow, or this, the tip of my triangle, so I'm gonna grab my direct selection tool, activate that anchor, and I'm just gonna move the point over. So in other words, I want you to off-center it a little bit. Okay, so stop the video and do that now. Okay, we're gonna add another one of these. I'm gonna grab my polygon tool again. Pick a slightly different shade, just so you can kind of see the difference here. I'm gonna double click, oops. I'm gonna double click and color, open my color picker this way, show you what you can do. Excuse me. And again, I'm gonna click and drag. I'm gonna hold down my shift key so it constrains that triangle so it's nice and level. And I'm gonna move that down. Now notice it stacks in front, okay? I'm gonna show you a way. Now I could go to object arrange, but I'm gonna delete this. I'm gonna show you a better way to do this. So before I start drawing that back one, if I click here where it says draw behind, and now I grab my polygon tool and I do that again, holding down my shift key, it's just constraining it. And I move that, it's gonna put it behind everything else that I drew. Okay, so through one of those methods, either hitting draw behind or just going to object arrange, I want you to put a second roof line and I want you to put it behind that first one. Okay, you may need to rearrange your chimney. My chimney got put behind, so I'm just grabbing that. So I just brought my chimney forward. So right now your house should look something like this. Our roof line is not done. We're gonna fix that in a bit. All right, go to File, Save. All right, and now we're gonna shear off the top edge of our roof later. But before we do that, I wanna apply and add some different characteristics to the outliner stroke. So zoom in on your front roof, select your front roof line. And this time I do want you to click on the stroke and I want you to pick a color. I'm going to pick something so that we can really see it. So I'm going to pick a weird blue color. And notice that your stroke here, you can increase the size of it. So if I can either type in a number or I can just use my arrow keys. You can even change some of the characteristics of it. So if I click on uniform, I can change, so it's going to change the shape and scale of it. You can't see it sometimes when it's really thin. I can even put in some funky shaped strokes in here. Some of you can really experiment. There's other libraries of strokes in here if you want to have some fun and play around with. We will have a lesson that goes well into these advanced options much later. But for me right now, I'm just going to pick an odd shaped brush. And I'm going to make it so that it tapers. Okay, so if you look closely, you can kind of see that it's not the same width all the way around. So go ahead and have a little fun, play with that, and put a stroke on the front of your roofline and go to File, Save. All right. Deselect everything. We're going to zoom in over by the door. We're going to add a detail to the door before we move on to our next objective, which is to combine shapes. And we're going to create a star cutout in this top window. It's kind of hard to see where we're going with this, but it will make sense. And I'll have you practice it on your own too. But we're going to use the star tool. It's in the drawer with the other polygon tools. And much like the polygon tool, if you use the arrow keys, it's going to increase and decrease the number of points. But I'm going to show you, and then I'm going to delete it, and I'm going to show you again some things you can do here. Let's reset this to white with no stroke before we drag. All right, so if I start clicking and dragging, if I use my arrow keys again, I'm going to increase or decrease. You can decide how many stars you want, how many points you want on your stars. If I hold down the shift key, it's going to make sure that I keep it level. You don't have to. If you don't want to, I'm holding down the shift key. Also, I want you to look right now at the center point of my star. I'm still holding my mouse button down. Now, if I decide I want the center, the very center of my star to be that size, if I hold down my control key and then continue growing, watch what happens. Only the star limbs grow. The center point no longer grows because I stopped it at that point. So go ahead and do that until you're happy. You got a decent star shape. Go ahead and stop the video. Do that now. All right, now we're going to go ahead and we're going to move this over onto the door. Now it's way too big. I'm going to show you what we're going to do to fix this. I just realized that I still will set undraw behind, so it's putting it behind everything. So I'm going to go object arrange, bring to front. If you were like me and you didn't change that, please, from here on out, click back on that draw normal. Stop and do that now. All right, so now let's go ahead and resize our star here so that it fits better. Grab your selection tool. I want you to move it so that the center part of your window. I want you to drag it down just a little bit. We're resizing it so that it fits the window. It's okay if it goes out a little bit further than the window, and it doesn't have to line up exactly with the window. But I'm just making it a little bit more appropriately sized. So it's going to be a little bit bigger than my window, but not super big. All right, so something like this, and then File, Save. All right, now we start to do some fun stuff. I'm going to show you how to use the Shape Builder tool. In our notes, we're skipping down to the Shape Builder section, how you combine or use different shapes together to create a new shape. What I want to do right now is I need to hide that star shape for a second. So click on your star shape. We're going to go to Object, Hide, Selection. It's going to hide that star shape. Just for a second, it's still there. We didn't delete it, it's just hidden. All right, with our selection tool, I want you to click on the brown circle. I want you to click on the red, and I want you to click on the bottom part of the door. So I've selected the ellipse, this thin rectangle, and the big rectangle. You have to select first when you're using the Pathfinder tool. Pathfinder tool is over here in the drawer. If you click on it, what we're going to do is we're actually going to add this and this together. We want this to all be one shape. We don't want the ellipse to show as a bottom ellipse. So all I have to do is come over till I see this mesh and the plus sign is saying it's going to add. So I'm going to click and drag down. It's literally adding those two shapes together. Okay, so we've added that. Pretty cool, right? Now what I want to do is I want to get rid of this section in here. With the Shape Builder tool, I want you to hold down the Alt key. And notice what happens is when I hover over that mesh of my, what is my red rectangle, I get a minus sign. If I now click, it deletes from that selection from here. So I basically use this to cut away from here. Now, because I didn't get all the way over, and some of you might have this issue, if you have this little doohickey over here that's left over from that rectangle that goes across, just select it and hit your delete key on your keyboard. That's all you have to do. Mine didn't quite overlap all the way, and that's okay, it's not a biggie. I'm just selecting them and deleting it. Pretty cool. So now we have like a half window, and I can change that color. So now if I want to change the color, I can make it a window color. So now you have that half window above a door. And we did that by using three different shapes, because this shape is not an easy shape to make. All right, let's go ahead and turn our star back on. So let's go to Object, Show All, and our star should appear. All right, now we're going to do the same thing with the star. We're going to use the star to cut out into the blue. So the star should be active. Hold down your Shift key and select the blue half. Go back to your Pathfinder, hold down your Alt key, and subtract from the blue. Don't click on with the brown of the door though. And I'll show you why. Because we don't want to deselect from the door. Sometimes you could be right in there. All right. And then you can literally just delete the rest of that. So we use the star shape on top to cut this cool star pattern into the window. All right, go to File, Save. Okay, we're gonna do this again. I'm gonna show you how to use the Shape Builder tool again. We're gonna do it a couple different ways, just we're reviewing. Zoom in on your top roof line and make sure everything is deselected. Grab your rectangle tool. It doesn't really matter what your presets are set as for this, because this rectangle is actually going to be deleted. I'm going to click and drag a rectangle, but where I want you to focus on is where it intersects that front line of my roof. You might want to watch me do this all the way through before you attempt. So I'm looking at where it intersects or what it cuts off that top edge of my front roof line, and I release. Okay, so I'm looking at this right here. Grab your selection tool, make sure this top rectangle is selected, and then holding down your Shift, you always have to hold down Shift to select both objects. So I'm selecting my roof and my top one. I'm gonna grab that Pathfinder, I'm gonna hit my Alt and delete that. And then I can just delete that top shape. So I've sheared off that edge. Now if I'm still not crazy about it, I can still make changes to it. I can click on it with my selection tool, grab my direct selection tool, and change that roof line if I need to. I can move those anchor points around. I can even move it all the way over if I wanted to. But here's the cool thing, by using that shear, notice my stroke, it altered that. It updated it to change the stroke down here. It added the stroke here when I cut it off. All right, so go ahead and do that, and then go to File, Save. All right, double check to make sure nothing's selected. This time I want you to grab your ellipse tool. We're gonna make some clouds here. Go ahead and pick a color for your clouds, don't care what color. And I do want you to apply a stroke. Again, don't care what color, don't care what size. You can put a crazy stroke on it if you want to. And I want you to click and drag three overlapping ellipses. Notice because they have a stroke, it cuts across. Well, what if I just want the outline around the outside, but not here? Well, that's the Pathfinder tool. Select all of your three clouds, grab your Pathfinder tool, and click and drag to now make them one shape. All right, do that one more time and have some fun with it. You can change your colors if you want to, don't care. I'll even show you what happens if you do have different colors. What's gonna happen? It can only be one color, so whatever the last color is, that's what it's gonna make it. All right, one last thing before we're done with our clouds here is I wanna show you in the control panel, you do have some options for making your shapes see-through, and that's the opacity. If I click it, I can take my opacity down. Notice you can kinda see through it. All right, so make some clouds for your above your house, make two or three or five or however many doesn't really matter. All right. All right, I'm done with mine. I'm saving. We are almost done here. We're gonna make a little bucket from scratch. We're gonna go back up to where on your notes it says copying parts of a path and object, joining separate paths. Sounds a little tricky, so make sure you pay close attention. All right, I'm zooming into the space to the right or left of my house, doesn't matter. I want you to grab the ellipse tool. Let's set all of our presets for this section to white fill with a black stroke. Let's reset our stroke, make it a basic stroke of 1, make it uniform. Don't have anything funky, just make it basic. And we're gonna click and drag an ellipse. I'm gonna suggest somewhere around like 1 inch by 1/2 inch. It doesn't really matter, okay? So we're making a bucket. It's gonna go in the front of our house. Here's where this gets tricky. We're gonna use this ellipse that we just made, but we're gonna just copy part of the bottom to make the bottom edge of our bucket. Start first by clicking on your outline, grab your selection tool, and watch very carefully where I start to click and drag. I'm coming in here. I'm not going above this path because I don't wanna select any part of this top edge. I only wanna select this bottom edge. So I'm just gonna start slightly above. Oops. I'm gonna click, Oh, you know why? Okay, this is a good learning experience. I was frustrated, didn't know why it wasn't working. We need to have zero fill on this. Good learning experience for us. The reason it kept grabbing the whole thing is because I was grabbing fill. So I don't want to grab the fill, I want to grab just that. So it's a good learning experience. Make sure your fill is set to 9. Grab your direct selection tool and click and drag. Now it should work. Okay. What I've got selected is just this bottom half. Now I'm gonna go to edit, copy, edit, paste. And now I have another section of line. Pull it so that it's directly down from the bottom part of our circle. And we're gonna alter it a little bit. You can make your path a little bit more narrow because if you know perspective, know that the bottom would be in a little bit. Okay. You can move it over. Deselect that. Now we're gonna connect these. You need to grab the line segment tool. We're not gonna change any of our presets. Come across over to your ellipse. Now it's very important, let it hover until your green word turns to anchor, not path, because you have to find that anchor point. Click and hold until you come down and you see the word anchor again in green. So what it's doing is it's connecting those two points. We're gonna come across, do the same thing here, find anchor, drag it down to anchor here, and release, okay? Well, right now, if I tried to fill this, I can't fill it. This isn't a closed-in shape. This is three separate segments. But we want to join all of this. So click and drag with your selection tool to select all of those different pieces. We've got 1, 2, 3, 4 pieces. You're going to go to Object, Path, Join. We need to do that 2 times because what it did is that right now it joined the bottom, but it hasn't joined the bottom with the top. So we're going to do it again. Object, Path, Join. You should get a line here that shows through. Don't worry, it's okay, it's cool, we're gonna fix it. So I want you to click on your ellipse, change your color, make it whatever color you want, click on your bottom part of your bucket, and then Object, Arrange, Send to Back. And then I would group those if I were you. All right, and then simply drag our bucket, put it in the front of your house. Perfect. Last thing we're going to do here, let's select all these objects and group them together. Okay, file, save. Stop the video now until you get to that point. All right, now we're going to add a new artboard. We are almost done here. Let's go to Window, Artboards. Right now we only have one artboard. We're going to add another one by clicking on this button here where it says New Artboard. Notice we now have 2 artboards. All right, this next step is a little tricky because we are going to be drawing inside. It's the last of our three modes we haven't used yet. Make sure you have nothing selected. Grab your ellipse tool. I want you to select a blue color with no stroke. And we are going to click. I want you to make a circle that is 12 inches by 12 inches. Should be a pretty big circle. And I want you to put it approximately in the center of the page. Now, if you are really specific about wanting it to be aligned, remember you can use that alignment and you can align it to your artboard if you need to. I'm gonna put mine in the dead center. Yeah, it was pretty close. Okay, this is where the tricky part is because we're gonna be drawing inside this circle. So with this selected, I want you to click on the far right button that says draw inside. Notice my blue circle is still selected. I have to click on that. You should get these dotted lines. If you didn't, stop the video, call me over because the next step isn't gonna work. All right, now that this is active, we're gonna grab the rectangle tool. Don't worry, it's not gonna look like anything happened. Don't change any colors or anything yet. And I want you to click and drag a rectangle that cuts off the bottom half of the circle. We're gonna change the color. Right now it looks like nothing happened, but it did. We drew a new shape on top, but it just happened to be blue. Change it to a green color. Whoa, notice it drew it inside that other circle. Okay, go ahead and deselect. We're still on draw inside. You should still have these lines. So I just clicked in the white space. I don't have this or this selected. We're gonna draw a little pathway here. So I want you to grab a new tool. It's a brand new tool, it's called the pen tool. I want you to set your color, just a different color. We're gonna make a sidewalk. Don't care which color you pick, but we're gonna come up to the horizon line or somewhere near here. Don't worry, it doesn't have to be right on it. I'm gonna click and I'm gonna add four anchor points to make a sidewalk. Right? It might not, may or may not be lined up. We need to click into our draw normal to get out of that mode. All right? Last thing we're going to do here is we need to select the grass. If you click on this, it's probably going to select the circle, but I want to select the green part. So you might need to double click and it's going to put us in what's called isolation mode. Notice this goes gray, so I've isolated here. So you might have to click a third time because when you have a complex object, which is what we just created, when you have an object that's drawn inside object, it's hard for the computer to isolate one part of the object. So that's why you have to double click to go into isolation mode and then select the part you want. I selected the green grass. And I can change my color if I need to at this point. So I'll just show you here. So if I decided I want a different color, okay. We're gonna use the eraser tool. So grab your eraser tool. And I want you to just paint an irregular, so it's not a straight line. It's kind of curvy. And release. To get out of isolation mode, you just hit the escape key on your keyboard. And now we have this irregular horizon. If this bothers me right now that my sidewalk is way higher, I can go back into isolation mode and I can pull that down if it bothers me. Okay. You can also get out of isolation mode by double clicking. Grab your house and your clouds. Move it over onto your circle, and because we drew this earlier, it's going to put it back. So all we have to do is go to Object, Arrange, bring to front, and there we go. Last thing we're going to do is I'm going to show you a little bit of fun. I'm going to show you the swatches panel so you can play around today. So if I wanted to change some textures and things, I'm going to show you the advanced libraries. The reason this looks like it's cut out is because my outline is actually the same color as back here. That's why it looks a little weird. All right, so if I click on my front, I'm going to ungroup this now. I'm going to open up my swatches panel. And there's this little button here that says swatch libraries menu. If you click on it, it gives you a bunch of different options. So instead of just a straight solid fill, it's going to give you some variety of colors and it's even going to give you some textures. So if I go to, say, textiles, it's going to give you colors of common textile colors. I can also go into the gradients and notice there's going to be some gradient colors that you can pick from. There might already be some preloaded patterns that you can apply. You can also add, there is some textile patterns in here. You just have to kind of weed through them and pull them open. The patterns here, there's basic and decorative, so you can pull some of those up. Have a little fun with that. You can change even your grass, whatever you want to do. Having some fun there. And when you are done adding textures and adding colors, go ahead and go to File, Save, and you are done for today. Good job.